수도 있지만 없는 것도 있잖아. 여기 맥비스리가 없잖아. 하이킨 has sp2 더블 방. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 atoms are on the same plane. One bond has a 2 electron. Pi bond is also 2 electron. And the sigma bond in the middle is another 2 electron. I didn't say double bond. I said pi bond. Then that should have 2 electron. Okay, Aiken is a nucleophile. Today we are going to start to learn chemical reactions. Yay! 드디어 화학의 꽃인 chemical reaction을 할 것이야. Aiken is a nucleophile because it has an extra electron. Remember that? Oh, good thing. Okay, cis and trans is a stereoisomer and it's not mirror image, then it should be diastereomer. Diastereomer also has two kinds, right? Cis and trans is a diastereomer. Configuration isomer also is a diastereomer. Okay, carbocation is sp2 orbital. How about the carbocation? Sp3. It has a long period. It's similar to ammonia. Okay, so based on this, we start to study chemical reactions. Starting from alkane. Okay, alkane. This alkene has a double bond, and we didn't learn functional group yet. Briefly, we have seen hydroxyl, alcohol, oxygen-connected carbon ether, and halogenated hydrocarbon. We just have seen the structure, but not real reactions yet. So alkene can generate many other things like this. Simple alkane is very boring. Alkane is the basic structure of crude oil, and if you take the crude oil, then it's mainly saturated hydrocarbon. It's quite boring molecule unless we give very high energy like heating or light energy. Then we can break it up, and that breaking usually generates radical and difficult to control. And statistically, if you heat it up a lot, then to make distribution. Carbon 7, carbon 8, that's a major project. Kind of a industrial scale of reaction can be done. For controlling the controlled reactions, we need to have some handle. That handle we call functional group. And we use this double bond as a functional group. Double bond, it has extra pi electron. Extra pi electron means electron rich. Now it has more chance to donate electron rather than take the electron. Right? Electron donating part is nucleophile. Opposite partner, electron poor part is electrophile. So, as I said, starting from the alkane, if you give a high temperature, if it's just only high temperature, then you may generate the fire. So you give some steam to cool down a little. And then cooking, then it can break up. And then if you generate the hydrogen, then remove some hydrogen and can generate the mixtures of different alkanes. This is the industrial scale. As you can see, almost 1,000 degrees, very high temperature and breaking up. And these are the reactions. So sometimes you generate, maybe one of those possible way is breaking up those bonds. You see single half L, that means one electron is moving, and you generate the radical as intermediate. If you put this parenthesis, this means intermediate. If it's a transition state, what do you put here? Double layer here, right? That's a transition state. So this is intermediate. Intermediate means it's a reactive, but you can isolate and characterize. Intermediate, and then if this means together, and remove the one molecule of hydrogen, and this is one representative chemical test phase to make the alkene. Not only this one, it can generate the mixture. So through this, it can generate the alkene. Degree of unsaturation. Already we have studied this. We practiced a lot with a different isomer of the drawing. So let's say, this one has a one double bond, and this one has a no double bond. Chemical formula wise, C2H6, and the other one is C2H4. By looking at this chemical formula, we can guess how many double bonds there is here, right? That's already we have a practice. And if it has a one double bond character, means two hydrogen of the atom is removed, we count that as a 1 degree of unsaturation. So the term of a degree of unsaturation is how many double bond characters are there. So if you look at this formula, C6H10, how many of the degree of unsaturation there? Bulpo-Bado, degree of unsaturation, how many?
Four.
How do you calculate? So double of this, 12, and plus 2, 14, and 14 minus 10, 2 out of 4 and divide by 2 because that's the bond number, right? So this molecule has a 2 degree of unsaturation. Then you have an option of a 2 double bond or 2 ring or 1 ring and 1 double bond or triple bond. Triple bond is pumped as 2 degree of unsaturation. So this the examples we have practiced already. And now, so this is only showing those carbon and hydrogen. So 2C plus 2 minus hydrogen number divided by 2. That's a degree of saturation. Right? Now, how about we have a different substituent, like the halogen. If a halogen is here, and that effect, halogen replaced with the hydrogen, seems like it's equivalent. Then halogen we count same as hydrogen, right? Easy, right? Halogen number we count as a hydrogen. Oxygen, how is the oxygen? Oxygen could be inserted in between any places. If it's inserted here, alcohol, it is inserted in between carbon, ether. So oxygen does not change. Oxygen can be inserted in any positions. Right? So oxygen, we don't count. Nitrogen. If you see nitrogen here, nitrogen case, NH2 position here, if you replace this with the H, then still M and H left over, and this should be zero, then this is the opposite effect of a hydrogen. Right? Halide was the same effect with the hydrogen, so count as hydrogen. Nitrogen case is the opposite. This is the minus one and this is the plus one. It's the opposite case. So summarizing all of this, the formula, degree of unsaturation, if you write down, it's like this. If you look at the carbon number, then 2C plus 2, this is the maximum number of hydrogen. And then you subtract hydrogen, halogen, and plus nitrogen, because this is the opposite to hydrogen. Okay? And divide by 2. So this is double bond, degree of unsaturation means number of double bond. Okay? Number of double bond. Double bond can be replaced with the ring structure too. Okay. We have the option of go to ring, cyclic structure, or the double bond. So we have already practiced this. So this is just a summary of the formula for this. Okay. Now, naming. So we have learned about the naming of alkane. So longest one is the mother backbone, and then we give the numbering. And then first the branching to give smallest number for the branching, and substituents alphabetical order. So those were general rule for the alkene, right? Then alkene also, we need to define the longest chain. In the naming system, alkene is the king. It's even stronger than alkyne. Alkene chain is defining those main ring. So that means here, if you count this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hexane, but if you look at here, it does not contain alkene. So alkene should be included in the numbering system. So it doesn't count as a 6, it counts as a 4 this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 this way. 5 is smaller than 6, but double bond containing backbone is important. It has a higher priority. Okay? So that's why we call this, it is a fully saturated heptane, but this is the double bond containing, we call pentene, not pentane. And substitution here. So positioning wise, next page. So first of all, the numbering system, including double bond, we find out the longest chain. Okay, that's the first rule. And then numbering, it has two options. So alkene is here. It can count 1, 2 alkene or 1, 2, 3, 4 alkene. Starting point of alkene is the number. So 2 alkene, 4 alkene, which one do you choose? 2 alkene is a smaller number. Okay. So then number wise 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hexane. So hexene, 2 hexene. Okay, that's a basic of the backbone structure. In this case, if you look at it, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, equivalent. Starting point is equivalent over 3, then you choose substitutions as the next option. Okay, then this is 2 methyl 3 hexene. Okay, so higher priority gives to position of double bond. Starting point is numbering 1, 2 position, 1, 2, 3, 4 position. Okay. And then substituents. Now this one. So 2 hexane as you have seen. And in this case, same molecule, 2 methyl 3 hexane. Okay. General structure is 3 hexane, now 2 methyl. Now here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pentene and 2 ethyl. And in this case, one now the two alkene then we call diene, two in, and the position wise 1, 2, 3, 1, 3 butadiene. Substitutions 1, 2 position, 2 methyl butadiene. It has the option of 1, 2, 3, but we don't call 3, 2. It's chosen here as a smaller number. So I can take the priority to determine the general backbone in this association. Now, originally we have used this, as you can see here, 3-hexene. Now, to make it a little more systematic, new system is rather than 3-heptene, we call it hept-3-ene. This is a new system. Still, we use both. Size and then in separately. So 3-heptene, hept-3-ene. A little different the naming, but we can understand. Right? So basic rule is the same. Longest one is a chain. 7, so it's a heptene. Positioning, 1, 2, 3 positions, 3-heptene. And then gives those be the substitutions. 2,5-dimethyl-3-heptene. Or 2,5-dimethyl-hept-3-ene. 이래는 이게 조금 더 드문 것 같지만 뭐 위에는 달라졌잖아. So this is recommended new version, but you can use that. Okay, here, one position, four position, 1,4-diene and 6. So 1,4-diene, hexa-diene and 1,4 the hexa 1,4-diene or 1,4-hexa-diene, and then substitution 3-propyl hexa-diene. So triene, diene, tetraene, in cut the again. Okay, cyclic structure. Similar to alkane structure, when we had the bigger cyclic structure, we call cyclohexane, right? Then this one should be cyclohexene. Okay, and then position wise, again the smallest number, so one position here, 1-methylcyclohexane. Option wise, you could start from here, 1, 2. Two position is also possible, but lower number, 1-methylcyclohexane. This one, diene. And the cyclohexadiene, position wise, one position, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you move the other way? 1, 2, 3? No, because you should count this double bond first. So go this way, 1, 2, 3, 4 position. 1, 4, cyclohexadiene. Okay, here, cyclopentene. And smallest number is 1. You should not count the go this way. You should go this way because the alkene is important. So alkene should be included in the system first. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 5, dimethyl, cyclopentene. Okay. A little more complicated than alkane, but not too much. The basic important thing is alkene backbone is the higher priority than any substitution. Other than that, just the name wise, ane into in. Okay. Okay, a little special other structure commonly shows up. So we have heard that this structure before, allyl group, double bond, and then one more, CH2. This was general structure for resonance forming. Okay. Resonance, we have one double bond and one extra one here. Either positive charges, negative charges, radical, all of them could form radical. That's why this structure is quite chemically interesting part. Allyl structure, and this is allylic position. If you don't have a one of the carbon here, just the alkene structure, this is not allyl. This is different. This is we call vinyl. Vinyl have the vinyl, the vinyl. So this is a vinyl group. Even if you make it shorter, here, this group, we call methylene group. So this one you may see a long time later, but this two is important. Allyl group and the vinyl group, those are different. You didn't learn yet, but this is a benzene, right? What do you call this group? This is a benzyl? Looks like it should be benzyl, but interestingly, this is benzyl. One more carbon, and this is benzyl, similar to allyl group. Okay? This one is called as a phanyl. Phanyl may be the closest name you could think. This is the phanyl. This is the phanyl. This is the phanyl. This is benzyl. And this is the allyl. This is the vinyl. So if you can recognize those, then you are middle level of organic chemistry. Okay? So those are quite commonly showing up. So good to know. Okay, these are the groups. There are several others that are named here, but most of the common thing you need to know is this one. Systematic name-wise, this is, if it is the alkane, this is the ethane, so this is called the ethene. Propane, propane. But more commonly, historically, we have used this one as the ethylene, propylene. Others, for now, you don't need to worry about. Ethylene, propylene, at least you should be able to draw the structure and catch those names. Ethylene, propylene. Okay? Ethene, propane. That's the systematic name. Okay, based on this, now we have double bond, and there is the naming and structure-wise, there's two isomers, cis and trans. So cis and trans, around those double bond, if that double bond is rigid and stable, then we can define cis and trans. Now, this pi electron, so this is sigma bond, and this is double bond, the pi electron. Pi electron, the positive side here, negative side here, they have a bonding. Sigma bond is a bond, but they bond like this. So this is stronger, and this is a little loose, but positive, positive, negative, negative, they make this bond. If this rotate up to here, 90 degrees, like this, now positive overlap part, negative overlap part is canceled out. This is rectangular shape like this. This has the relationship, what we call orthogonal, chikabangay. That means there is no interaction. If it goes the other way, now positive and negative, and negative or positive, this is anti-bonding. But this is neutral, no interaction. That means practically pi bond is removed. Even though there is the electron there, one electron here, one electron here. So this is almost like two radical. And they do not interact to each other. No interaction between two partners. That's mathematically we call orthogonal. And chemically speaking, no interaction. Okay, that means this double bond is effectively broken. And it's almost like a freely rotating. Then it can go to cis, go to the trans very easily. So isomerization of cis and trans is through this pi bond breaking. And this happens through this rotation of the pi bond. To achieve that, you need to have a high energy. Then usually heating is not enough. Heating is vibrating every bond in the molecule. You don't know which bond is breaking first. Usually single bond is weaker than double bond. So single bond may break first by generating radical. So to get this specific energy, usually you need to use light energies, sharp photon, and then donate and then make it excited into this. So through this, it can form cis form into trans form. Isomerization can happen. If you look at these two case, here cis, here trans, we can give the name. If it is the same, if it is the same structure here, then we can say cis and trans. If you look at this structure, same here, is this a cis or trans? Here, so same side, cis, opposite side, the trans. Right? Here, same one side, is this cis? This is the same molecule. If you rotate this over, then no difference here. Right? And if you have ABCD all different, then this molecule, can you say cis or trans? Yes. Then, what is this? Is this the cis or trans? If they have at least one pair, it's the same structure there, then we can define cis and trans. But if all different four, then it's a little strange to to call whether this is cis or the trans. So we need to have another systematic naming system, like the RX system in the stereochemistry designation. So in this case, by dividing this in between the in the middle, and then you define which one is the higher. That rule is the same for RX determination. What was the factor to determine the higher priority? In RS 1, 2, 3, 4, we counted, right? What is the criteria? Atomic number. Right? Higher atomic number is a higher position. And if it's the same atomic number, then what's next? Atomic weight. Okay? So exactly the same rule you apply, and then you count which one is higher and which one is lower. If those two are higher, if those are higher, is in the same direction, the same on their position, then we call it G. G is in German, it's a zusammen, means a together. So similar to, this is similar to cis, right? So English is a common language in chemistry we are using right now. So sometimes if you want to designate something else, we take something from Greek, something from German. Germany was the first country to develop organic chemistry, so they coined in these kind of terms. G is the same direction. E entgegen means across. It's similar to trans. Okay? So it's the opposite side, E pon, and same side, G pon. Okay, let's try. So here, which is higher between these two? Carbon, hydrogen. Carbon is higher. Chlorine, carbon. Chlorine is a high. Opposite direction, ethan. So when we had RS form also, we had those are RS form, usually we put parentheses like this, RS form. EG2, this is also we put parentheses. So this is a stereochemistry designation. Right? Through double bond, through chirality center. This definition can be used. Same rule for the atomic number priority. Here, hydrogen met the carbon. This is a higher. This is the opposite of this. Right? So this is same reaction, and this is the G form. This is the E form. Okay, how about this? Is this a G or a E? Here, this is a higher. Here, which one is a higher? Carbon, same. Then just check the next one. Okay? So carbon, oxygen. This is a higher. Higher, same direction. G configuration. Okay, this is naming of the G, S, G, E for trans cis. And on the name. Now, property. Eigen property. One is a cis form, one is a trans form. By looking at this arrow direction, so which one is more stable? Trans is more stable, right? Why trans is more stable? Maybe steric hindrance, the same side, okay, is steric hindrance this side, right, on the same plane. So this carbon and this carbon and this carbon is on the same plane, right? So it's an eclipsable, and there's a bigger group than the steric strain there. So that's why this may be a little more unstable. This will be more stable. And if there is any catalyst which can convert these two, then this can be, this relationship is resonance, correct? Is this resonance? Then? Isomerization or more general term? Isomerization and equilibrium. This is equilibrium, right? So equilibrium can be drawn that way or this way too. This way too. Okay? Half arrow and half arrow. So this is also equilibrium. resonance is this, right? This is resonance. Resonance only electron is moving. In this case, atom has moved. Isomerization. Okay, now if we change this alkene into alkane, this is a hydrogen addition reaction. So for the alkene, we have seen those are general type of reactions. Addition. If it's the opposite reaction, elimination. Right? And then what else? Substitution. Changing one thing. So that's not alkene. So anyway, substitution. And the other one was rearrangement. Inside the moving of a functional group to other positions. So here, this is example of addition. And alkene. Trans-alkene, cis-alkene, both of them, if you add hydrogen at the molecule, and same product is formed. If you draw reaction profile, which one was more stable, cis and trans? Trans was more stable, right? And product is the same. Reaction is also the same. Then you can draw two reactions at the profile, the same reaction profile. And this side of product is the same. Now we can draw cis was a little unstable and trans was a little more stable. And you can draw two reactions in the same other reaction profile. Maybe transition state is also, this is a little higher and it is also higher here, maybe. And this is a little lower. Then activation energy, we don't know exactly which one is higher. Maybe this is different, but maybe this is also different. This difference and this difference is the same, then activation energy is the same, right? But delta G, value-wise, so this is a delta G, and this is a delta G. So equilibrium constant-wise, this is different. Thermodynamically, this was less stable. So trend of cis moving to the product is more equilibrium shift because energetically this is more unstable. So it forms relatively bigger Gibbs free energy they use, so it can go to this way. So if you calculate this delta G values, which one may be bigger, cis form or trans form? If you look at this electron the reaction profile, cis form and trans form, which one has a higher delta G? Cis is higher because it was more unstable and becomes a stable state. So that's why if you calculate those values, you can see those difference. Cis has about minus 120. Trans is minus 106. Minus means it is preferred to go the old directions. So if you compare this delta G values, then you can compare their original stability. Because the product is the same, product is similar, as you say, not exactly the same though. So by looking at those numbers, ethylene versus substituted one, disubstituted, tri, tetrasubstituted one, and if you look at this table, can you tell more substituted versus less substituted one? Which one is more stable? Is it? More substituted one has lower delta G or delta H. Means those energy difference is smaller. That means this one was more stable than this one. Okay. So if you ask the question, how do you know whether this is more stable than this one? By doing the same reaction and change them into similar alkane, and then those energy are the difference between reactant and product. And if you compare those values, then you can get relative stability. Anyway, this is the conclusion. In alkane, more substituted and they are more stable. It's not absolute number, this is a relative number. Reference is alkane. Assuming that alkane is similar to each other, and then if you compare those the double bond hydration, the hydrogenation of the reaction, then more substrate, more stable. How do you explain? If you ever learned organic chemistry before, then try to explain why more substrate one is more stable. Just before, we have seen cis and trans. It's isomer. Okay? Look at the formula is the same. And substrate number is also the same, just the friction is different. In the case, eclipsed form versus anti form, anti was more stable because of the steady strength. Right? But in this case, substitution is different. More substituted one, we observed it's more stable. How do you explain? 생각 안 하고 그냥 외우면 외우면 잊어버리면 다음에 다시 그쪽으로 잊어버리면 돼. 이런 걸 생각을 자꾸 해봐야 아 따져보니까 그랬어 하고 또 거짓말일 수가 있어. 지금은 단순한 걸 배우지만 이제 점점 더 복잡한 게 자꾸 들어가겠지. 그러면 그냥 일일이 테이블 다 외울 수가 없어. 문제를 보면서 그래프들을 끄집어낼 수 있어야 돼. Why more substituted one is more stable? Explanation is like this. So pi electron, in this case, this is localized in this small box. Two carbon site. It's localized inside here. When you learned particle in a box model, particle in a box, in the box, there is a particle behave like a wave. And then particle size is becoming bigger and bigger, and those wave forms some energy state, and if you solve this Schrödinger equation, and particle box, smaller one and bigger one, which one occupies more stable energy state? Bigger one is more stable. Bigger one has longer wavelengths comparing to shorter wavelengths, shorter wavelengths versus longer wavelengths is more stable. Entropy also can explain that way. Entropy, if you have this limited space, if you need to be here versus if you have more options to move here, then statistically they move tend to move to the other side and they occupy two spaces, two states they can occupy, then entropy is also increased. So in this case, now if it has limited space like this, then it's kind of standard. And then if you have more space added here, actually this one is not very much. The real extension of that is one double bond is connected to the other double bond. Then pi electron, this is looks like a disconnected, but if you draw those pi electrons, those pi electrons are all connected in the same space. Then this is much more stable than a single one. This one you are going to learn in the organic chemistry too, but that one we call conjugation, extension of a pi electron. Okay. Here, similar effect happens. Not really conjugation, but in this case, if you look at the structure, this is a double bond, and there is a CH3 here. Double bond is electron rich or poor? Electron rich, that's why it's a nucleophile, right? And CH, this H comparing to carbon, is more electron negative or more electron positive? Hydrogen, carbon, which one is more electron negative? Carbon is 2.5. Proton, the hydrogen is 2.1. That means this is H bond, slightly this is electrons shifted this way. A little weak, but this one is a delta positive, means electron poor, and this electron rich pi electron can be partially donated to this hydrogen. Effect은 그렇게 크진 않은 거야. 그렇지만 이런 effect 때문에 this electron, this pi electron is sharing this space together, similar to conjugation, and this kind of the explanation they call hyperconjugation. Through this effect, if you have a more alkyl group around, then it has a little more space, it can share the space. That's why this becomes a little more stable. That's the explanation. Different kind of explanation. If you have less substituents, then this is sp2, sp3. The bond strength between sp3 to sp2 is a little stronger than sp3 to sp3. If you have more substituent position, then this interaction sp3 to sp2 is a little more. This is here too. This is only one. This is another way of explanation. Maybe same observation, they try to give different explanations. sp2 is a little more S character, and when it interacts with another sp3, it has a little stronger attraction than sp3. So this is one kind of explanation, and this hyperconjugation is another kind. 어느 쪽이 더 끌리는지 몰랐었습니다. 둘 다라고도 주장할 수도 있지만 사실 그렇게 샌드랍과 샌드컨스가 아니기 때문에 프레퍼런스에 이렇게 쓸 건데 hyperconjugation 때문에 혹은 이런 반대의 차이 때문에 anyway, more substrate type the alkene is more stable than less substrate. Okay, now using this alkene, let's look at the reactions. Addition. So if you look at this reaction, what do you guess? What happens? 무슨 일이 일어날까? 분자를 보면. 진짜 뭘 보라는 거예요? 누가 일렉트론이 많고 누가 일렉트론이 부족한가? 누군가가 서로 끌린다면 파지티브 서로 일체를 보고 파지티브 네가티브 서로 끌리고 일렉트론 주는 놈이 있으면 받는 놈이 있어야 뭔가 반응이 일어나고 그 측면으로 봤을 때 무슨 일이 일어날까?
所以，in this case, alkene electron rich, not super rich, but it has a pi electron nucleophile. HCl, if the withdrawal at the one molecule, actually HCl delta minus delta plus. Most of those organic chemistry are the reactions. If it's not radical reaction, so we think about the polar reaction. And which side is the weaker part? Which side is the stronger part? Electron rich, this is the pi electron. Looking for electron poor part. Electron is moving. Double head, two electrons moving. Both of those pi electrons moving. Two hydrogen. And this electron is pushed to this. So first reaction is reaction happens through this. This is released. That reaction you can expect. And this is the reaction mechanism. Into double bond, if you add HCl or HBr, then proton, this one is attacked here first, electron poor part. Electron is donated, that's why electron side is positively charged. And this one obtained the extra electron, it becomes a negative charge. So that's why Br- comes back and interact with this positive charge, it can make the bond carbon Br-. We have seen similar reactions before, right? So this reaction, form of reaction wise, two double bond, H and Br is added. Addition reaction. Okay. Opposite reaction is elimination. So, if you draw the reaction arrow profile, we have seen this before too. So, first thing is attack that hydrogen, actually there is a proton, H+, and proton added intermediate is formed. And then, Br- comes back, and then recombine this together, and then form the product. In this case, reactant, product, first transition state, second transition state, and intermediate. First activation barrier, this is activation barrier, activation energy or activation barrier. Delta G for equilibrium constant calculation is the difference of energy, reagent, and product. Delta G zero. This activation energy is the delta G double level. So this reaction profile tells many of the things. And now, by looking at this reaction, HBl, HCl, basically similar reactions. Then proton is added here, and then chloride is added to the positive charge position, forms this product. Here, HCl, HBr similar, this reaction seems like HI added. If you look at here, acid was added separately, phosphoric acid. And then KI was added. So I is I minus source here. Proton sources came by here. If you combine this together, this is similar to HI. HI, HCl strong acid. HBr stronger acid. HI is even stronger acid. Similar situations you can make. Maybe HI is difficult or dangerous to handle, too acidic. And you can add I source as a salt. KI, very stable, similar to sodium chloride. And then you add acid separately. So it forms HI kind of in situ. And the reaction is similar to HI reaction. So proton is added first and form those intermediate. And then I attack and then terminate. How about this? Now there's no highlight. So water is here and acid is given. Now we are expanding those reactions. Acid is added to the alkene, then acid has a proton, electron poor. Then electron donate, 5 electrons are donated to the proton, proton is the catcher. And we don't have a halide here, but we have now water here. Water's oxygen is also can form OH minus. OH2 is also is a weak nucleophile. Electron rich species here, lone pair electrons. So exchange this halide with water, and that position water goes in, and then one proton is abandoned. So proton, acid proton is added here, and OH is added here. To summarize this reaction. The first step of reaction, you added the acid, proton, and then you added another nucleophile, reacted with the carbocation. That is the reaction mechanism of addition reactions. Even to have this biscan reaction, 아니다라고 보기 때문에 하나씩 잘 챙겨보고 서로 비교를 해서 뭐가 다른지 바꿀 수 있는데 그냥 reaction 듣고 배우고 더 생각하면 그게 그거 같아가지고 대단히 헷갈리지. Electron rich alkene emits acid, then proton is captured. Electron is donated to the proton, and intermediate particle charged intermediate is formed. And then any nucleophile, water halide, they can protect their position and finish up their addition reactions. This is the first type reaction we are learning. Now, if you draw this kind of chemical reactions, this is a general form of like reactant and reactant, and then arrow. And you put solvent. Solvent is less important for the reaction. Important, but to understand the chemistry itself is kind of a background, right? So solvent and conditions. If you have a catalyst, then you can add the catalyst here too. Catalyst is not reactant, right? Catalyst does not change. So if you add acid here, and maybe acid here, you can put. So this is a general way. Reactant, arrow, product. And condition, usually solvent, compound, and other conditions. So Or another option is like this. Reactant, and then important reagent here, and other conditions, catalyst and solvent, temperature, condition at the bottom, and product. So this is common way, this format or this format. Okay. So if you write your reaction report, okay, when you write your reaction procedure, so similar way, you put your reactant, and then conditions, and product. This is the standard form. Can be reagent here too. Usually, in this case, it's a large excess amount of reagent. If it's a one equivalent, one-to-one reaction, usually you use this way. If this is a little large excess amount of reagent, but used up, and this one is incorporated here, then this is another option you can choose. And condition. Now, biological reaction drawing. It's a little more complicated. To draw everything is a little too complicated. So this is common way of biological reaction drawing. Reagent, substrate label, and then product. And then reaction-wise, it seems like a phosphate is added here. And there is maybe kinase is involved here. This is a catalyst. And this is a cofactor change. ATP generate, ATP donate this phosphate, and then ADP is the byproduct of this. So that means actually two reactions. One reaction is a phosphate, phosphorylation happens here. The other reaction is a dephosphorylation happens here. But main interest that we have is that this is the main reaction. So we draw those main reaction part, and this treat as minor reaction. So this is a biological the way to draw those chemical reactions. In a sense, this is similar to oxidation reduction reactions. It always happens together. But we draw only our product and substrate, our main interest. And the other partner is put here, that's kind of a reagent. So using this, now for the reaction of additional reaction, now one group. Malkovnikov sounds like some chemist name. So what happens here? So this reaction again, alkene and HCl addition. Cl, H is added here, Cl is added here. I didn't explain other possibility, but there's another possibility like this. Cl could be added here, and H could be added here, then this is another example. But if you do this reaction, this is not formed. Only this is formed. Why? Is the explanation of this Malkovnikov group. So he studied this chemistry systematically and found some general trend. So this is one type. So double bond, in a sense, this is equivalent. So HCl addition, then you have options. HCl or ClH, right? So there's always two options. Then which one should be the main product is the question. Let's look at the example. So this is the same one. In this case, Cl is added here and H is added here. 그냥 보면 이거 구조 떠올릴 수 있어야 돼. 이렇게 보면 알킨인데 이렇게 보니까 tertiary butyl chloride 가 되겠네. H가 이렇게 들어갔고 Cl이 이렇게 들어갔다. Another example. If you have this one, method here, cyclohexene, HBr, HBr, HCl, similar chemistry. And then option was HBr or BrH. Product is this. Now, by looking at the two reactions, what is the general observation you can find? What is the general trend? More substituted position. This is a less substituted position. Right? More substituted position take up, not hydrogen, take up functional groups. Less substituted position take up the proton. So more substituted one is more further crowded. Proton added here. Same thing. Proton added into less substituted position and more substituted position is added to the function of A. It could be BL, it could be OH, it could be the same. So this observation was made by Markov Nikov, and he put his name. My rule is if you do chemical reactions on alkene, most of the position will take up for the function of it. So, in this case, what do you expect? Example. Here, one proton, one alkyl, one proton, one alkyl. Even though this is a little bigger, in this case, the situation is similar. Then you will get mixtures. Dominantly, one side is much more subacidic. Then you can see a clear result of microphonicol. But this is a similar situation, slightly different. Then you may get a mixture of this. Okay. Maybe 49 and 51, but anyway, it's almost 1:1. So, by looking at this, here HCl, this is a bond, not this is a bond. Again, same structure, this is a bond, this is not bond. Okay? More substituted position is a bond. That's the observation. Now, here, by following that observation, what could be a product of this reaction? This is the HCl reaction, right? First step, chi bond attack proton. And Cl comes back in the group, the product. You want to ask a question? Okay, you want to ask a question? Okay, you want to ask So here, this is 5-membered ring, this is more substituted one. Cl is added here. Okay? Proton is added here. Okay? So this should be the product. Like this. Now, following these reactions, to make this product, what would be the starting material for this? Of course, there are many reactions we can make this, but we just learned one reaction. Addition reaction of alkene, then to get this product, what would be the starting material? Then imaginary, you need to think about reverse reaction, right? The reverse reaction is elimination reaction. You should have double bond. Okay? I remove these, and then you should remove neighboring hydrogen, one of them. It can be this way, or it can be this way, or it can be this way, like this. Three possibilities. You have to make this product, you have this way, this way, this way. By the way, all of those, if you do this HCl reaction, do you expect to get this product? Question is whether this is microphonical product. How is it? Is it? Yes, it is. So this position is a tertiary position, three substituted position, that's a product. In this case, comparing this one to this one, this is the more substituted position. This one and this one, this is the more substituted position. This one, more obvious, this is more alkyl, this is two alkyl. So all of those cases, if you do this HCl reaction, product will be formed this one. This is Markov-Nikov product. Okay, now let's explain why this happens. Intermediate, first step. Alkene plus hydrogen. It donates lone pair electron. No, sorry, pi electron. And I captured the one proton. Then that donated position becomes positive. This positive position, positive charge containing carbon species we call carbocation. Carbocation, sp2, planar structure. planar structure, and if you compare to the stability of this carbocation, again, more substantively, carbocation is more stable. Similar situation to alkene. More substituted alkene is more stable. It was right. And in the case, the explanation was hyperconjugation. In the case, there was an extra electron. That electron was shared by neighboring hydrogens. But in this case, observation wise, anyway, the stability was like this. More substituted one is more stable. So that is experimentally measured by cleavaging of carbon to chloride. That cleavage energy is higher, means this is more unstable. That energy is smaller, that means that this is more stable. Similar are the analogy of hydrogenation reaction of alkene. And anyway, by measuring these values, we know that the more substituted carbocation is more stable. Explanation: by looking at the electron map, blue color, electron deficient, reddish color, electron rich. Carbocation already has a positive charges, then it's electron poor, right? If they have a lot of the surrounding electron rich species, is more stable or less stable? Electron poor state, if there's anybody around donate more electron to the center, then it's a happy situation. So if you look at here, this is electron poor. Alkyl groups, they are relatively a little more electron rich than hydrogen. So this effect is a little more electron rich species can stabilize this center carbocation. Because of this effect, more substituted carbocation is more stable. Because of this observation in organic chemistry, especially in carbocation, alkyl group is considered as a weak electron donating group, relatively. Alkyl group compared to hydrogen, hydrogen doesn't have much electron. Carbon has a little more electron. So alkyl group is considered as an electron donating group. Around the carbocation, if there are electron donating group, that can stabilize this carbocation. So more substituted, tertiary is more stable than secondary. Secondary is more stable than primary. So if you compete primary with the tertiary wins almost 99-1. Okay. This is the explanation of addition reactions Markov involved. So in this case, if it forms the carbocation, then this is the electrons that donated selected here, this electron poor state. Okay, up to here, we have learned of alkene's addition reaction. Reaction condition was electron rich alkene, electron donating, and the partner was acid was a partner, first partner. HCl, HI, or separately, KH, KI, and acid separately. And proton is captured to form carbocation. Right? Carbocation stability wise, more substituted carbocation is more stabilized. Now, any kind of a negatively charged one can react with this carbocation. It could be water, it could be halide. That position is a more substituted position. That's the result of a Markov involvement. Okay. That's the first reaction we have learned. Alkene reaction with addition chemistry. Okay. So we are going to expand this further and further with different examples. So 하나씩 하나씩 잘 챙기면서. Okay, any question for today's lecture? Chapter 7 is almost done, only 10% left. So next time, we are going to continue to move to chapter 8. Okay.